manipulations of Cambodian nationalism. This documentary is the second one in this series, being produced to show the real history of Cambodia, a new country created by French separatists. During colonialism, the French colonists used divide-and-conquer technique to take the land from Siam. Before the French came to Indochina, the land where Cambodia locates today belonged to Siam. If we take a look at the map drawn by the colonists themselves in 1886, we will see that at least half of Cambodia was still part of Siam. Even Angkor and Phnom Wihan Temple were in Siam. Before the arrival of French colonists, there was no country called Cambodia. When the French colonists arrived to Indochina, they took over Vietnam and started drawing border line to separate the land between Siam and Vietnam and created a small country called Cambodia. They used the ruin of Angkor as a symbol for nationalism and created an identity of Cambodia as a country of Khmers. Phnom Penh back then was just a city under Siam. King of Phnom Penh was sent from Bangkok to rule the region. Kings of Phnom Penh like King Ang Duong was raised in Bangkok for more than 20 years. He was sent to rule Phnom Penh, which is a city of Siam. French separatists tried to link King of Phnom Penh with Varman kings from Angkor period. They make believe that the kings of Angkor who built stone temples such as Phnom Wihan Temple or Angkor were Khmer. This is what a famous French historian, George Sede, said after years of studying about Angkor Varman kings and Khmer kings. He was trying to link the last Varman king and the first Khmer king mentioned in the Chronicle of Cambodia. But he failed. Page 196 in his book, he said, no link has yet been found between Chea Varman IX, the first kings mentioned in the Cambodia Chronicles, which begin around the year 1350 with a name that is presumably posthumous, Nirvanapada. Apparently, the French historians couldn't find the link between the first Khmer king of Cambodia and the last Varman king of Angkor. Hilary Grant from Memorial University wrote in his paper Manipulations of Cambodian Nationalism, From French Colonial Rule to Current Polity. Nationalism in Cambodia centers around two recurring themes, the grandeur of Cambodia's past and the moral superiority of the ethnic Khmer, both of which originated from the colonizing French. These views have been manipulated by different political players throughout history, creating a situation where nationalism is imposed vertically from the powerful elites to the general Khmer population. The vision of a lost, golden era has not always permeated the Khmer population. Many of these historical influences, along with the belief in a superior ethnic Khmer, were introduced to Cambodia through French colonial rule. Daman dates the formation of the Protectorate of Cambodia to August 11, 1863. The French are credited for having rediscovered Angkor Wat in the 1850s. Previous to this rediscovery, the Cambodians thought of Angkor Wat as a place of pilgrimage rather than a vessel of history. The French wished to define their new colony and its people, giving it a national identity, and so implemented a form of stage theory in which the state of Cambodia they witnessed was compared to the wonders of the past. This led the French to view Cambodia as a fallen nation that could be projected to the outside world as needing to be civilized. This ideology was then extended to the formation of ethnic types. The French claimed that the Khmer had Aryan blood that made them morally superior to the Yellow Chinese and Vietnamese. This French interpretation of the Khmer as the descendants of a magnificent civilization was in stark contrast to earlier Vietnamese colonizers' interpretation of the Khmer as savages whose nature is evil and vicious. Hence, the French propagated a view that the weakened yet superior Khmer needed French protection while the French needed Cambodia for the cultural riches of Angkor. Therefore, both pillars of Cambodian nationalism were built by the French and not by the Cambodians themselves. This means that when subsequent governments make reference to national identity, they are in fact using the images constructed by the colonial French. In conclusion, the country called Cambodia never existed before the arrival of French colonists. Phnom Penh was just a city under Siam, like other cities in Siam. In the next episode, we will take a look back to Angkor period and we will show that Varman kings of Angkor are not related to Khmer kings of Phnom Penh. Stay tuned for more episode from Lee Porter channel. You can also add friend to my Facebook at Michael Lee Porter. Hope you enjoy this episode.